بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, I welcome you all to a new podcast. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a means of benefit and to grant us all goodness. Ameen. Today, we live in a world where there are many new ideas, new phenomena. In fact, we also have new technology which changes every day. All this comes with a change in the way we behave, the change in our ideology. In fact, it comes with people who are now experts in certain fields and they start to teach and promote their ideas. The question is, as a Muslim, it is my belief that Islam is a complete religion. This is my belief and this is your belief. Let us examine this belief a bit further. This means that whatever goodness we need in our lives, whether it is to do with deen, whether it is to do with the religion, or it is to do with our worldly affairs, we believe that there is some sort of guidance and there is some sort of ruling that has been taught to us and given to us by Allah and His Messenger. So, for example, even when it comes to contemporary issues, whether it's cryptocurrency, credit cards, or test tube babies, all this as a Muslim, because I believe that Islam is a complete religion, I also believe that when it comes to these contemporary issues, Allah and His Messenger have given us some sort of guidance and they are Islamic rulings. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ, speaking about a certain ruling. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when it comes to these matters, especially contemporary matters, the people who are able to do istinbat, the people who know the Quran, who know the Sunnah, they are able to understand and extract a ruling from the Quran and Sunnah. What's actually very interesting is, as I was reading a lot about marriage coaches, money coaches, life coaches, a lot of what they have to say and what they teach and the concepts they have come out with, whatever is correct and good, we find that generally it's been taught to us in the Quran and the Sunnah. It is my belief as a Muslim that as long as it is something good which I need in this world or in the next, there is some sort of guidance and some sort of instruction from Allah and His Messenger. In fact, in Sahih al-Bukhari alone, there are so many ahadith which speak about business, entrepreneurship, even when it comes to things like development, your interpersonal skills, how to interact with others. All this and much more has been taught to us by Allah and His Messenger. That is why one of the main reasons for this podcast is to go over some of these topics and to look at what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us. And that is why we will be going over some of the ahadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. We all know that the most correct book after the Quran is Sahih al-Bukhari. Bi-ithnillah, we will begin from the book of buying and selling, Kitab al-Buyu', and look at some of the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We find that these ahadith are not only to do with buying and selling, but there are also other topics which are covered. We won't go in any particular order, but our main aim is for us, firstly, to see what the best of creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has taught us, and also for us to be able to benefit and implement these matters in our day-to-day lives. Bi-ithnillah, in the next episode, we will look at what Islam has to say about money. Is a Muslim allowed to be rich? For you to be religious, for you to be close to Allah, is it okay if you have money or not? Bi-ithnillah, all that and much more. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all goodness. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.